greatest, biggest, and scientist in the world.
Two is?
Mitochondria.
Three?
A cytoplasm.
Four?
A nucleus.
Five?
Seven, the yummy tank.
Okay. The blue one. Which is the blue one?
Cytoplasm.
Okay, and which one again?
Golgi apparatus.
Golgi apparatus. Which one again?
Yummy tank. Lysosomes.
Lysosomes. And which one again? Microtubule. Excellent.
Hi friends, this is Jason the scientist. Jason, why do you call yourself a scientist?
Because scientist is a person who does science research and science experiments.
Wow, look at this guy. He says he's a scientist, and that a scientist is a person who does science research and science experiments. That's awesome, Jason. So, do you have something to show us today that is scientific?
Yes.
What is it? Can you show us?
A cell.
Wow. Guys, look at that. There's another one there. Yeah.
There's another cell on the TV.
Right. That's another cell. So this is a 3D printed cell.
Daddy printed it.
Wow. That's amazing. So Jason's been learning about this. And he's going to tell us a little bit more about the cell. Let's watch. From Jason the scientist.
Yeah.
And he's gonna talk about what this cell is.
Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing.
Whoa, there's another cell up there on the TV.
What? And it has all the parts on it, right?
But and it has names over there.
And it has names on it.
But I thought I have my cell that have names on it.
Okay, so how about you tell your friends about the names and the parts of the cell, right?
You touch it, okay?
Okay, I'm going to touch it for Jason. Good. Okay, guys, Jason says he's going to tell us a little more about the cell.
Oh, yeah!
Okay, Jason, the scientist, can you tell us what is a cell?
Yeah. A cell is a small living unit of organism.
Wow. A cell is the smallest living unit of an organism.
Okay,
and Jason, I can see a lot of things swimming in here. Are they organelles?
Yeah.
What are organelles?
Organelles?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes.
What does it mean?
What does it mean?
What does organelles mean?
Organelle means?
Yeah.
Organelle means little organ.
Yeah, right. Organelles means little organelles.
That's the same on the TV.
And it's the same on the TV. Okay, awesome. Now Jason is going to tell us a little bit more about the organelles in the cell. So here we go, Jason.
Mommy, what are these grumpy things?
They're all organelles, and you have the same thing over here. So let's tell.
Where are the grumpy things?
There, right there. Okay, so we're going to show all of that.
So where are the what are these grumpy things' names?
They're all organelles.
You can tell me the grumpy ones. The grumpy ones.
Oh, those around the cell? Like this one?
Yes.
Alright, so Jason just said that organelles means little
organs.
Little organs. And there are so many organelles in the cell. Jason, can you help us name some organelles in the cell?
Okay.
Way to go. Okay, let's start from here, Jason. So when you look at the cell, the white part
cell membrane.
Is the cell membrane. Okay, now we're gonna go closer inside.
Is this the cytoplasm?
Yes, you got it already before I can ask. So what the organelles are swimming in is called?
Cytoplasm.
So guys, the cytoplasm is the fluid inside the cell, that the organelles swim in, like in a swimming pool.
Okay. That's in the beach, like a beach.
Okay, so like a beach. Okay, all right, Jason. So let's look here. You said the cell membrane, right?
Yeah.
And then the swimming fluid is the cytoplasm.
The nucleus. How about the nucleopause?
Oh, and we have some dots. That's the nucleopause?
Yeah.
Okay, how about the ribosome?
Why the three ribosomes? That's you, but we need five of them so it can give them enough power.
Wow, but that's not ribosome, Jason. What's the energy?
Oh, mitochondria.
That's the mitochondria.
But the water tree mitochondria, maybe we need five mitochondria so we can power up.
Yeah, that's right. The cell has a lot of mitochondria in there.
But why are there only three?
Because this is just a representation of the cell, not all of it. So there is more inside. But that's a good observation, okay?
Okay, so yes.
So how about the green one? What's it
called? Golgi apparatus.
That's the Golgi apparatus. And then what's inside the nucleus?
Nucleolus.
Okay, so Jason has mentioned a few parts of the cell.
I did it!
Good job! Good, so we're
going to talk about lysosomes.
Oh, I forgot that. Uh-huh.
And now the... Okay, we're done.
We're done?
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe now you can talk more about the different organelles.
Can we cover this now?
Okay. So now that we're going to talk about the organelles, Jason.
Now we're going to
mention what they do in the cell, right?
But how about we need to cover this food before?
You want to color them?
Yeah.
Okay. We can do that. We can color them.
Let's do it.
What colors do you have now?
I guess do the orange for mitochondria.
Okay, so Jason's gonna find the mitochondria on the cell. Let's watch Jason if he's gonna get it right. Whoa, he actually got that right. So those wobbly structure in there is the mitochondria.
But this is the dark color, not the light color. I need to use a light color.
Oh, let's put some more detail to it and see if it's gonna work. Keep coloring it. Add some more. So guys, Jason is trying to color the mitochondria. Yeah.
I think it's getting a little lighter.
Okay, keep adding some more details to it. So whilst Jason is coloring, Jason, what does the mitochondria do?
The mitochondria. Oh, it is the powerhouse of the cell.
Wow, that's amazing. So it gives the cell all the energy that it needs
to get sunlight through the air and all the way to the plant so it can grow.
Yes, it's gonna
do that.
Okay, Jason, can you find with your color? Can you find the nucleopores? Where is the nucleopores?
But I'm not done going. There's one more to go.
Oh, there's more of the mitochondria?
Yes.
Wow, this cell is gonna get a lot of energy then. That's amazing.
No, we're not going to get a lot of energy because maybe if three is a unit number and three is not going to get the energy, maybe we need five of them to get the energy.
That's a smart idea. Three is not enough, right?
No.
The more mitochondria we have, the more the energy in the cell, right? Wow,
yeah.
I see. That's a good observation there, Jason.
Now there's one more before we do the other.
Wow.
Here.
Guys, so this is basically how he gets to learn about the parts.
Daddy, are you picturing us on drawing?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Daddy's picturing us from drawing.
Okay.
Daddy, Mommy.
Daddy likes your coloring.
Mommy, how about you use a color too?
Oh, I'm watching because Jason is showing me a different organelles in the cell. Right now, he's coloring the mitochondria, right?
Because we are done.
Oh, almost done?
Oh, yeah. We are almost
done. Guys, Jason is done coloring the mitochondria.
No. Oh, no, because there's three more to go over here.
Oh, okay.
But if there's a lot of reds, your damage is going to get way more power. So, like, there's a lot of reds, so that means it's going to get power soon.
Wow.
Yay.
Power, energy to do things, right?
Yeah, energy to play, energy to work, energy to jump so high in the sky.
Wow.
Okay, I'm done calling the mitochondria.
Good job, Jason. Good coloring, I love it.
Wait, how about when we are done calling all these and the microtubules is right, do we have a right so we can call the microtubules?
I have to check the color box and see if we can get a white one.
Okay, so yes, check the color boxes.
Color boxes. Oh. We got another color here, Jason.
Yeah, but
can
but
you
wait,
spot
what?
The nucleus? Where's the nucleus?
Guys, Jason
is going to find the nucleus and he's going to color it for us.
It's going to color green?
Yeah, you can color it green. So your friends will know which one is the nucleus, the green color.
But the nucleus is not green. The Golgi apparatus is green.
Oh,
you forgot.
Okay, so where's the Golgi apparatus then? Which one is the Golgi apparatus? Oh, that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
But Mommy, why do it inside here? And it's always not coloring.
It's not coloring that much, right? Add some more details. It's going to pop up. Add more. Yeah. Try.
And you succeed.
Okay.
It's not working.
Just give it a little more push. A little more detail. Yeah.
I'm not doing it.
Now, you know, can I help you?
Yeah.
Let's see if I can put some more color. Maybe this way. Maybe that way.
Mommy!
Yeah?
I'm going to choose another color. So I can choose.
Let's choose another color.
I'm choosing. Oh, no.
What color did you pick now? Blue. Did you get the blue one?
Yeah, but okay, I don't know which one can be blue.
Let's find another organelle because we're trying to
Mommy.
Spot the organelle. So, Jason.
Mommy, if you're done with this, how about you give to me and then I'll color the lysosome. The lysosome is also green.
Oh, where are the lysosomes? Can you show us, Jason, by coloring?
Here is the lysosome.
Oh, so those round spotty ones are the lysosomes?
How about I can color this part green? Oh, Mommy.
Yeah, keep coloring.
I know.
More.
There's
much more details.
Wait, there's one yes thing. Okay, I'm done with the green. And Mommy, don't forget, there's one yes thing that needs to be blue.
Which one?
The cytoplasm and the endoplasmic reticulum.
Where's the endoplasmic reticulum?
I'm doing the cytoplasm first.
That's a lot of space, Jason. How about you start with the endoplasmic reticulum?
Okay.
Good job. Okay, guys, Jason is trying to spot the endoplasmic reticulum.
I spotted the red. Spotted the red.
Good job. Can we see it? I can see it if you put your hands there. Okay. Yeah, you can hold it down like that.
Mommy?
Yeah? again.
When I'm cloned, you need to clone some more organelles that is you.
Okay.
Oh, mommy, I know which organelle was you.
Which one? You're coloring it, right? The endoplasmic reticulum.
I know the endoplasmic reticulum is blue, but something else is blue.
Okay.
Like the cytoplasm.
Okay, Jason, so the endoplasmic reticulum, how many do we have in the cell?
50. Oh, we have lots of. Wait, we have wolf ear and smooth ear. There's two ears.
Two types of ears?
Yeah.
And they're called what?
The rough ear and the smooth ear.
Oh,
like the rough ear is on your head, and the rough ear
feels like your hair, right? How rough your hair is.
Yeah.
And the smooth ear is smooth like your hands. Is that what you mean? Like your skin? Wow,
yes.
That's a good example. So why does the rough ear feel rough? What is on the rough ear?
On the rough ear?
Yeah.
What
does it have?
DNA. Oh.
The rough ear?
Yo, wait. The rough ear, no. Like the rough ear have ribosomes and capsules, and the smooth ear doesn't have ribosomes.
Excellent. Good job, Jason. Mommy, that's very true.
Mommy.
Yes.
My brain says I think I need to color another thing. So can you color this? And if you're done, you need to say I'm done to me, and then I will respond.
Jason is telling me he needs help. So he's basically spotting the endoplasmic reticulum. Jason, how many types of ear did you say we have?
Two.
Two types,
yeah.
And they are called.
The wolf ear and the smooth ear.
Oh.
The wolf ear have ribosomes attached to it, and the smooth ear doesn't have ribosomes attached.
That's
to it.
Why they are smooth, right?
Yeah.
And the rough ones has the ribosomes, and that's why they are rough.
Rough, rough, rough. Wow.
Now I
get it. The rough of parts.
The rough part. And
no, the rough of parts. That is in Paw Patrol.
Whoa.
Now what do we do? What do you do?
We're coloring the endoplasmic reticulum, right?
Mommy.
Yeah. Okay, Jason, that's very good color, and I love the details you put on it. So friends can see
Mommy.
That the blue is the endoplasmic.
Mommy.
Yes, Jason.
What do details mean?
Details means you're adding some more. Okay.
Let's color together.
Jason, what are we coloring?
We're coloring the we're going to Golgi apparatus.
We're coloring the Golgi apparatus. Why do you make your voice like that when you mention the Golgi apparatus?
We need to do this because.
So what does the Golgi apparatus do, Jason?
The Golgi apparatus do, mommy, is go, mommy.
Yes.
Can we just go here so we can connect it?
Yes, what's the function of the Golgi apparatus? What does it do?
I don't know what's function.
It means what does it do? What does the Golgi apparatus do in the cell?
It customizes the proteins.
Wow.
Mommy, let's do this one.
So the Golgi apparatus customizes the proteins that are produced,
mommy,
in the cell.
How about we do this one? This
okay.
One. Can I color it?
Oh. What are you gonna color, Jason?
The new Clolus.
The new Clolus?
Yeah.
Oh, where's the new Clolus?
It's inside the new clothes.
Inside the new clothes. Oh, wow.
But why is the new clothes going?
It's like somebody's opening his mouth, right?
Yeah, is that somebody eating and opening his mouth?
Guys, this is what he's trying to say. Because we have the new clothes and we have the new clothes in there. So it's like an opening with, you know, that structure there. Smart, Jason. Okay, so he's coloring the new clothes now.
Yeah, but Mommy.
Yes, Jason.
Why is this a different color? When is this purple, it always changed to a different color. I don't know that.
Wow. It's purple. I can see purple. Okay, so you can color all this one. So what's the bigger one?
The bigger one, yeah. New clothes.
What does the new clothes do, Jason?
It controls the cell from its environment. It controls the cell.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm not done.
What are you coloring, Jason?
The new gloss.
Okay, can I hold it for you so we can see what you're coloring? Take your hands from there. Thank you. Good coloring. So what does the new gloss do, Jason?
I told you it controls the cell.
The new gloss controls the cell?
Cell from its environment.
The new gloss is the controlling...
Center of the cell.
Wow. And what does it contain?
It contains DNA.
The nucleus contains DNA.
Yeah.
Do you know the full meaning of DNA, Jason?
Which full meaning of DNA?
D, N, and A means deoxyribonucleic acid.
Oh, I get it now. Mommy, get it means I know it.
Yeah, I just told you, so you next time you know that, okay? And I can see some spots in the nucleus, Jason.
That's nuclear pore.
That's the nuclear pores?
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe when you finish coloring the nucleus, you can use a different color for the nuclear pores.
But I'm done coloring the nuclear pores.
Okay, so guys, look at that. Jason says those little holes in the nucleus is the nuclear pores. What color do you want to make the nucleus?
Brown.
Brown? Let's see if I can find a brown for Jason.
I don't know. I didn't know there's brown in there.
A lot of colors for you, Jason. Gentle.
Oh, let me do the brown. Okay.
So Jason is going to spot those pores on the nucleus. Wow, that's amazing.
It keeps going out.
Do you need help?
Yeah, I need
help. Can I help you?
Now I need a different color to color the rest of them.
Okay, guys, so I think Jason is done coloring the nucleus pores. He's tired.
No, I'm not.
This is basically how it looks like.
Those
pores in there.
Do we have white? Let me check we have white or no.
Alright, Jason is coloring something else. Those round things in there. Jason, what are those? What are they?
Let me think. Oh, yes, I know what it is.
Right?
Yeah, let me see. Oh, yes, lysosomes.
The lysosomes?
Yeah.
What do the lysosomes do?
The lysosomes is the garbage collector. Yeah.
The garbage collector?
Yeah, the lysosomes take out damage and worn out cell parts.
Oh, they take out the worn out cell parts
and they break
the damaged cells out. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you get a boo-boo, cell membrane, cytoplasm,
point it.
Oh, yes. I know it. So is...
What's the purple one?
Oh, yes. Nucleus.
Nucleus?
Nucleus. Nucleolus.
Nucleus.
And... A mitochondria.
Mitochondria.
What are these? Oh, yes. I know what are these. So they are...
The round green round ones. What are they?
Oh, this one? Yes. Oh, lysosome.
Lysosome. So how about the green wobbly one up there?
Wobbly ones? Okay. Is that them away?
Yeah,
okay. Oh!